I was struggling with some decisions in my life. I had just put my dad in the nursing home. And so when I started working on this piece, I didn't really know the direction that it was gonna go. So all these different feelings I was feeling about putting my dad in the nursing home and stuff, I don't know if I tried hard to put it in the sculpture, but I think it kind of came out in the way the trunk turned out with all the different trials and tribulations sometimes that we go through. And plants go through a drought, and then in the spring they end up blossoming despite all the struggles that they've gone through. And so I just kind of let it take me on this journey, and came up with this idea to invite other artists. During the kind of the COVID thing, it was everyone on social media was kind of struggling with their creativity, and you could kind of tell by some of the posts. So I put a post on Instagram. I think I have enough blossoms. So come and see the tree when it's done. Thanks. Because I wanted to do a sculpture that included other artists, but I didn't want to do something that would cause a lot of drama. So then this idea hit me, well, a blossom is fairly simple, and just about anybody could come up with their version of a blossom, and it would just kind of be a community thing.
I made a blossom before this, but I didn't know how to weld, so I used super glue because I didn't know how, I don't know how to weld.
Trig and his sisters, they each made a blossom for the tree, and they go to school here in Lemon, so they're local kids. I went to high school with their dad, and so they glued together these fishing lures and different things with hot glue. And so then when I welded it to the tree, it just melted and all the petals fell off, so I felt terrible.
So John invited me out to his house so that I could make another one. And this was the final image of it.
So he came out a couple days ago and made a blossom, and got to use a welder and a plasma cutter, so it was a new experience for him. And now when he comes to look at the tree, he'll be able to point his blossom out to different people.
He had like a small thing. It's like kind of like a hitch thing, but way smaller. And then we pounded it with a hammer to make that go in a bit. And then we welded. And then we grabbed 5 fishing spoons from what I brought, and then we welded them to the carriage bolt, and then we welded these 2 to a carriage bolt, and then we welded the carriage bolts together to make this.
I've known John since he was a child, but never really associated with him until one day he called me and he said, "I'm looking for a junk pile with some specific items in it." And I said, "My neighbor has got the perfect stuff. It's from that era." And then after that, he calls once in a while and we go junking. You know where there's a junk pile? Or he'll say, "I found one." And I have a kind of an idea what he's looking for, so we can go through rather quickly.
I often think, if I was in Italy, I'd be carving sculptures out of marble. But we don't have a lot of wood here. We don't have a lot of granite, marble, but we do have a lot of scrap metal. So that's the medium that I choose to work in, and there's plenty of material to choose from in this area.
John asked if I wanted to make a flower, and I'm a gun nut, so I took a couple of cartridges, a 50 Browning machine gun brass and a 30-06, and I split them lengthways, bent them into petals, fixed them together. Brass kind of tarnishes with age. Sometimes it gets green, and I thought it would give a constant life to the tree. When it gets to that point, there'll always be a strangest golden green flower.
I think we got a pretty good group of people here in Lemon that have really appreciated what I'm trying to do here. So that helps me want to keep doing more and keep coming up with fresh ideas. Thank you.